I'm here with Rashad Vence. He's an MMA fighter out of Baltimore. Tell me about yourself, Rashad.
Well, I'm one of the only MMA fighters that has a doctorate degree. And so initially I started out wrestling. And my wrestlers, to me, it looked like they just didn't push themselves. And I told them that I can go to a whole nother sport that I don't do and I can do good just because of my work effort. So I went to, I took a boxing match to stay in shape and I actually won it. And so once an MMA coach found out I took a boxing match, he said, let me start teaching you MMA. So I took a couple boxing matches because I was working on my doctorate degree. I didn't.
What's it in? What's a doctorate in?
My doctorate is in education.
It's not easy. Not an easy field.
No.
You're a very smart guy.
Working.
Reporter, come here, Richard's in. He has a PhD. He's an MMA fighter who won his boxing match, went to school, got a PhD. What's up, coach? So he's telling me he's going to coach here too, but he's a killer. One of the few in Baltimore that does MMA.
Okay,
you started, Richardson's a boxing star, we'll be
What's
champion
up?
In no time. Richardson Hitchens, that's his coach right there.
Yeah, I seen him before.
They're from New York. Where's your accent from?
Baltimore, I'm from Baltimore.
Do you understand guys in Baltimore?
Yeah, I got shit to do. That's how they talk.
But they talk so fast, I'm like, slow down. He went to the Olympics representing Haiti. Very talented kid. Yeah, he did.
Wow.
Richardson's a good dude. So you're working on your degree. Why? You could be a principal at school, you could be an administrator. There's a lot you could do with your degree. Why fight?
Well, the thing is, when you fight, you step in that cage and you can push yourself. You can't make no excuses, and it's like a goal. Like I have a book coming out, it's called Goal Setters. I always set goals for myself. So I pretty much, everything I want to do when I die, I want to be like, I stepped in the cage.
You achieved it all.
I won the title, I did it all.
Right philosophy, leave it.
Win or lose, I went out there and I gave it my best shot. And I admire people like PACQUIAO, this is Senator,
eight division champion.
Yeah, he's a champion.
Legend.
Ronald Hopkins. So I grew up admiring those type of people. So now I admire Shaquille O'Neal. He has his doctorate degree. He's an NBA player. So I wanted to be like getting that select few.
It's amazing. Well, I commend you for that. It's not easy to go to school, even if you're not a pro athlete, even if you're not training, just to focus on school. Because I tried to get a master's and I was too busy with work. But after, what did you think of Manny's last fight?
I thought it was good. I mean, he constantly forced his way inside. He stayed busy inside, kept head movement. He didn't back up. He didn't really let Keith Thurman get off anything. It was an excellent fight.
Who would you want to fight? If you could fight, you're 155. Would you like to fight Conor? Would you like to fight Khabib? Well, you're smiling, but if you're at Nate Diaz. Nate, for me, is pound for pound king of the UFC, but who would you want to fight?
Conor McGregor is my role model.
Yeah. Okay, sometimes you gotta
Yeah, it's not really a preference, but like I admire people like Conor McGregor, what's the guy named? Michael Page. I admire those guys. So when I train, I always want to be like him.
That's cool. No, you want to be, but would you like to fight him?
Not right now. A couple more fights.
Okay. Yeah. You only have 5 pro fights, 4-1. But I got to ask you this. What's more dangerous, boxing or MMA, in your opinion? Because you do both, and you're in a boxing gym right here, Upton Boxing Club.
I would say MMA is more dangerous.
Why?
Because the thing is, when you box, you can break. In MMA, once you get on the ground, somebody can keep on hitting you.
And I've seen it.
The ref is not really going to stop it until you see blood.
I've seen it in MMA. Guys on the ground knocked out get hit 5-6 times. Very
good. Yeah, it's scary. So
boxing, but boxing is dangerous too. Continuous blows to the head.
Boxing is dangerous. Both of them is dangerous. I mean, I've did wrestling.
Run DMC are calling.
Huh? Okay. Run DMC.
Isn't that Run DMC song?
Yeah.
Okay. But you saying for you MMA is more dangerous?
MMA is more dangerous for me.
Rashad, tell people where to follow you if they're watching.
You can follow me on Instagram at Dr. Shaw Pro. You can find me on Facebook at Rashad Vance. And I have a YouTube channel. It's called Dr. Rashad Vance.
All right, look out for Rashad. One day he's going to fight in the UFC. You've seen him here first. He's a badass. FaceLoserBoy.com. Let's sit back reporting. What's better, to choke someone out, knock someone out, or make someone tap out? What do you prefer?
I prefer to knock someone out. That's the hardest thing to do.
That's why when Tank has 21 wins, 20 by knockout, it's hard.
That's a lot of work. Yeah, he put in a lot of work to get that way.
That's true. People don't know that. I see him. You see him.
Yeah, it's a lot of work.
Well, nice meeting you. Thank you so much for the interview.
Nice meeting you.
Elie Seckbach reporting.